better by the day. Anything that is man generated gets worse by the day. Are you understanding me? If it is God, then it gets better. If it is man, it gets worse. If it is God, the best comes towards the end. It keeps improving. If it is man, it starts dying and keeps disproving and keeps expiring. Therefore, your marriage is not supposed to degenerate. It is supposed to regenerate. Therefore, your marriage is not supposed to go worse and worse and worse. It is supposed to get better and better and better. Because it says you have kept the good wine till the end. Normally, good wine comes at the beginning and bad wine at the end. How come you change the thing? The wine you gave us at the beginning looked very sweet, but we never knew there were better ones that will come at the end. Have you understood now? It gets better when it is God. Again, the Bible says to us, when they had no wine, from there I'll start my teaching. There comes a time in relationship or in marriage when wine finishes. Every marriage experiences this. Every marriage experiences this. When the wine finishes, that is where I begin my teaching. There is time for everything. In every marital relationship, there comes a time when wine finishes. When wine finishes. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1. I will manage myself.
Let everybody be awake tomorrow.
Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1. The Bible said, to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose. There comes a season like that. Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 17. The Bible says, I said in my heart, God shall judge the righteous and the wicked. For there is a time. There is a time there for every purpose and for every work. And for every purpose
and for every work.
Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 11 again. The Bible says in verse 11, he hath made everything beautiful in his time. Also he has set the word in their heart, so that no man can find out the work that God maketh from the beginning
to the end.
Blessed be the reading, the hearing, and the doing of
God's word.
Marriage has four seasons. Marriage has four seasons. And the seasons keeps rotating. Sometimes you are in this season now, you move to the next one, you move to the next one, you move to the next one, you come back to this one. Seasons, it keeps rotating. Once you spend a long time in this season, then you enter this season, then you quickly run back to this season again. But some, they spend a long time and their marriage ends.
Depending on the season they entered into.
I will show you now. Some people know how to activate the seasons while others stumble into the seasons by accident. Some people know how to activate the seasons in marriage, season number one, season number two, and some people decide to stay in one, they activate this one because it's a good season, while others do not. They only enter season. Hey, it's a very good one. Tell you, they're now in marriage. If he sparks for a rat, you will mind. Are you understanding me? At the spring season, it is very exciting. Weaknesses are concealed in euphoria. Weaknesses are concealed. They are covered up. You don't even see.
And there is hope. There is joy, excitement, and hope.
You always want to talk to her. Even in the middle of the night, you don't mind if she disturbs you. Even when you are doing anything, if she calls, it's okay. If he calls, it's fine. You always take a excuse. Can I talk to my fiancé? Give me a few minutes. Then you talk. There's joy. There's excitement. It's like there's a butterfly in your stomach. That's always doing. It is just sweeting you. You're not very happy. When you sight anybody that looks like that, you are very happy. When you sight anybody like him, you're okay. The music he likes, if he's playing on radio, you tune it all. I just want to say I love you. Say, wow. Then you remember, then with some little water will come out of your eyes. You cry a bit in the office. You wipe away your tears again and continue your job. It is spring season. It is sweet in you.
Ah,
The attitude during spring season is anticipation. You are always anticipating that what surprise will he surprise me today? Or what surprise will I surprise her? Should I buy her a shoe? Should I buy her a sweet? Oh, should I buy her a flower? Anticipation. Optimism. You're always thinking positive. Oh, she's the finest person on the face of the earth. I'm telling you, see the way she walks. Even other girls, they walk like this, they walk like this. She's always walking straight. You're always optimistic. The way she talks, you admire it. Are you understanding me? Gratitude. You're always grateful that you met her or him. Oh, I thank God I met this fellow. Wow, what a solution to love. There's a lot of love. And there is trust. There is trust. Even if he tells you he has slept with 100 girls, you don't care. They couldn't get him. I'm the fortunate person that got him. Oh, glory to God. You don't care. He tells you that he raped his grandmother. You don't care. As long as he didn't marry his grandmother, he wants to marry you. So you are feeling good. Are you hearing me? You just trust him like that. All right? Actions. What are the actions that you see during spring season? Nurturing. You nurture each other. You want her to get a good job. You want her to pass exam. You want him to get a good job. You want him to pass his exams. You want it to be well with him. You want his business to... You nurture each other. You try to help each other to make progress.
That's one of the things that happen during spring season. Planning. Planning again is another one. You plan with each other. You plan what to do, where to go to.
Even what does not concern him, you will call him to plan. Tell you, I wanted to go to this and that one. Let us
plan it together. And then you plan.
She will not go.
But you plan.
Where will you go to day one?
You plan it.
Day two, you plan. She will not be there. You plan.
That happens when the spring season is there. Are you following me, somebody?
Yeah.
I remember the first time I came to Kenya, I was still engaged to her, but we are not married yet. We planned it together as if she was going to go. Yes. When I got to Kenya, as I got my line, bam, she was the first person to have my number. So I would tell her what I'm about to do that day, where I'm going to. Then I would tell her in between where I've gone to. What? Yes, that's it. So the communication is very strong. The next one is communicating. The communication is serious. In fact, we have to get some 2 extra lines just for communication, because those people were doing free calls at night. MTN and Globacom. They were doing free calls at night. So she got her own, I got my own. By 12, we just hook up. If we talk, and this one goes up, we'll use the other one to continue. In fact, we use it for night vigil, prayer, meeting.
There was just something to talk about. How many of you has it happened to you before? There was just something to talk about. In the middle of the night, though. I remember now, when she calls me at night, maybe I've gone to preach in US. After preaching, when I get there, she calls me, I'll talk to her for a few minutes. I think, please, let me sleep a bit so I can gather myself for the next day's preaching. But that time, now, hey, that's my fiancé. Excuse me.
Am I right?
You charge back. You close that chapter. When you escort him back, to then you decide to part ways in between. You call her again. Are you on your way? Say yes. Are you very close? Are you reaching home? Is your 2 eyes closed? It is spring season. Am I saying the truth? It is spring season. The flow is continuous. The flow is continuous. You want to see each other regularly. You want to talk every time because it's a flowing stream. It's the beginning. In reality, spring season is time for flowers to shoot out, new grasses to grow. Water, you know, the streams are flowing, it's not dry, everything is fantastic, things are just fresh, everything is healthy. That is the first season of every relationship and marriage. Excitement in my life together, great hopes for the future, planting of seed for a great future. It is time to plant seed for a great future. But do you know, carelessness during springtime in a relationship can cause some infection. And then your season will suddenly change. Carelessness. Many times at that spring season, we get very careless. One of the greatest problems of the first season of every relationship is carelessness. You just get carefree. I don't care. They tell you he drinks. I don't care. You people did not want me to marry him. That's why you're telling me he drinks. Then you go to him and say, do you drink? In fact, even if you drink, I'm okay. Ah! That is, you already planting seed for the next season, and it may be very bad season. Are you hearing me, somebody? Carelessness is one of the greatest problems of this
first season of every relationship.
Carelessness. In a relationship is when you are also over rigid. Because if you don't know that 101 things, you will say I do and you will regret doing. Because springtime will finish very quickly and you find yourself in dry season. And you find yourself in problems suddenly. And you feel like breaking away from that relationship. You regret you ever met that fellow. Are you hearing me, somebody? So you need, one of the days I'll teach on 101 things to know before you say,
I do. That one is single summit. Married people can also come so they can learn some more. All right.
Now, if you get very rigid, that person can say, no, I don't like you. You are forcing me to do that I don't want. If you are also very carefree, you can...
Of marriage.
The second season of marriage or relationship is the fall season. Fall. Is fall the same thing with autumn? Huh? I don't know, but fall. Fall season is when all the leaves on the tree begins to fall.
How many of you have seen that season before?
When all the leaves fall. I've been in the U.S. during fall season. You will see trees naked. Naked trees everywhere. Not one green thing on it. You will look at forest. You just see trees standing with no leaf for many kilometers. See, if you do not handle the spring season well, you will move into fall. Others move into another season that I'm going to show you. Others move into another season if they treat it well. They smoothly.
Because they did not handle it well.
That is when you see everybody begins to see each other's fault. This is when everything in a marriage that looks very colorful begins to experience a fall.
Like leaves fall off tree due to serious wind.
This is the initial stage
of disagreement and misunderstandings.
The beginning
of misunderstandings. Fall. It happens both in relationship and marriage.
Hey!
Careful here. Then your mother that you have not called since you entered that relationship, you now start calling your mother, Mom, I just want to say I love you. Because you are trying to balance up in case it fails. You have where to run. You have where to run to. Fear. Sadness. You are not really happy. You just be managing yourself. You smile by force. Things are falling apart. Dejection. You feel dejected. The person may not have rejected you, but you are dejected by yourself. You don't get dejected. You feel it. Apprehension. You feel the person have arrested you and chained you. You feel tied up. Discouraged. Why? Resentment. Feeling an attitude of concern. Anywhere they talk about it, you quickly raise up your head to check whether they have a solution to your problem. Uncertainty. You're uncertain whether it will work or not. Blaming each other. Be blaming that fellow. If it's not my fault that I ever agreed for you. Then you start blaming. You start passing blame. You didn't greet me this morning, that's why. It's the one that did this and that one. She's the one that did this and that one. They be passing blame. When you are passing blame and you refuse to acknowledge your fault, you're already in a fall season. The tree is still there, but it doesn't have leaves anymore. The leaves are falling off. The leaves that were there when you were in spring is already falling off. Are you following? Actions. Neglect. When you are in fall season, you start neglecting each other. You don't care. Are you going to church? I don't know. So if you like, come. If you like, don't come. I'm on my way. The marriage is in the fall season. Are you going to work? Say, please, find your way to the office, please. I have some important things. It's a false season. But now, you don't even care. We don't want to talk. I don't want to talk to you. Hold yourself. Yes. Failure to face issues. The atmosphere around falsism is drifting apart. The two of you be drifting apart gradually. You don't talk about things I used to talk about before because just drift apart. You don't care whether it knows it or not. Disengagement. Your hearts are no more engaged. Sense of detachment. You detach yourself from that fellow. You start looking for life on your own without that fellow. In case it scatters, you can carry on. Neglect of each other and blaming of each other. I don't care. You decided not to greet me, let her not greet me. The other day I even tried to hug her, she just removed my hand. So fine, let her go and hug the tree. I'm okay. And so on and so forth. And it becomes very overt and people can know that this relationship is having a problem. It may be covert for a while, but after a while it becomes overt. Everybody can see it. I heard of a certain pastor. Nobody knew that him and his wife were having problems. So one day, I think the pastor was introducing somebody to the wife. I want to get the story well. And the wife gave the husband a slap. And the pastor pretended nothing happened and carried on. Everybody knew something had happened. Slapped the husband inside church. The husband carried on. That relationship is in a fall. Many times when relationships are in fall season, things will be quarreling in the house. Then visitor will come. The two of them will start smiling. You're welcome. You're welcome. Sweetheart, you better my beautiful wife. Can you? They didn't say that before. Say, can you get him some good drinks? In fact, that meat you gave me yesterday night, he didn't eat. Can you give him some to eat? And the guy is eating, thinking everything, but he's not fine. Are you hearing me? So they cover up. They go out. Everybody minds their business. They come back in. The quarrel continues. They shut it. As soon as they shut it, they say, I know you are an idiot. They say, Father, I've been waiting for us to get home. Your grandfather is a real idiot. Then they start again. That relationship is in a fall season. Things are falling apart. Everything is falling. Are you following me? This is the expectations over expectation. You are over expecting her to overcook. So she didn't do it the way you wanted. So you are disappointed. Or you've expected that man to manifest like a sex machine. And he does not have that capacity. So you are disappointed. One lady came to report the guy to me and said the guy could not manifest. I said, what? But it's over expectation. It's not that the guy could not, but over expectation. When you have wondered about and you have had a lot of negative things and you stored it in your brain and you want that man or that woman to manifest in that vein and he cannot, then you enter false season because your expectations were not met. Are you following somebody? That's one of the bad things about dating many people before you get married. Especially when you fall into sexual matters. When you fall sexually before getting married. As such, when you get married, you will never be satisfied. Because you will think the man should manifest like one guy that used to manifest like a machine. In the days you are fornicating.
The money was not available anymore. While a day, immediately trouble starts instantly.
Are you following me? Over expectation, then disappointments, then there's stubbornness. At such time, you see people display their stubbornness. See, I will not talk to you until you kneel down and beg me. I will not talk to you until your father shows up physically. Your father, your original one, father. I will not agree until we go back to the pastor that joined us together. I will not talk to you for the next 1 year until you bring all your salary and drop it on my legs. All kinds of people get very stubborn and very rigid at this season. Are you following me? Denial of sex or conjugal rights. That's when it starts. Hey, don't touch me. Excuse me. I told you I will not touch you until you bring your father, until your mother kneels down to beg me, so on and so forth. Wanting to be begged, at first it satisfies emotionally, and so on and so forth. At first season, people fall into more problems. Every marriage passes through this kind of season. Every relationship passes. Kind of season. Are you following me?
Many times, if you do not come out of this fall quickly, you will enter the worst season,
and that will terminate your marital relationship. But every marriage passes through this season.
If you do not walk to...
I have a question. How many of you are married here? If you are married, raise your hand. You are married, raise your hand. Have you experienced fall before? If I experienced fall, raise your hand. Me, I've experienced it before. You, have you experienced it before?
You wonder, hope I prayed well. No, Pastor Dennis cannot experience it. It's very holy. It's holier than... of you know spring when you are very excited, when you are very happy, when you are you go to a shopping mall together, you go everywhere together. Fall, if he follows you, you warn him. Say, what are you following me about? What is it? Hey, must you leave me? Thank you, Jerry. Leave me alone, Jerry. What? Spring season, when she's holding you, you are fantastic. So also, when a marriage is experiencing winter, there is cold relationship. How are you? Fine. Please, stop asking me. How are you? Cold. It is full of harshness. How are you? Why are you asking? Must you ask? It is full of bitterness. You remember the little things that he or she did to you, and it makes you very bitter. See, the same thing was done to you by a house help, but it didn't pain you. But the one she did to you or he
is more painful. It's
that season.
It's very bitter, harsh.
When the dreams of your springtime is covered with cold ice, all the plans you planned together, when butterfly was flying in your stomach, that time you don't even want to care about it anymore. All the vision you are going to treat each other. Vision, call, dream, you need. I'll drop it somewhere. You're already in winter season. And cold is beating the two of you seriously. When the feelings of closeness is already at the dead end.
There's no closeness anywhere anymore. Everybody their own.
At that time, there is divided voice, there is divided force,
and separation, which is leading to divorce.
At that time, you don't want to see that person any at all. His presence adds more problem to the problem you have,
or her problem, or her presence.
What are the emotions during winter season? The emotions during winter season is hurt, anger. You're feeling hurt
in you.
You're feeling angry inside you. You're feeling disappointed inside you. You are lonely, even when the person is lying down in the same bed with you. Very lonely. At winter season, you are not dejected, you are rejected. There is a deliberate rejection. Say, don't touch me, please.
Rejection. That is winter.
The attitudes during winter, negativity. Hey, I won't wear the shoe. There is a feeling of negativity. If he greets you, say, hey, what does she want? This one that she's greeting me now.
The blood of Jesus. Are you understanding me?
Hold your hand, you shiver, say, hey,
Lord of Jesus, Father, have mercy. Everything you are suspicious about it because it's winter season.
Hopelessness, discouragement, and frustration. You are discouraged, frustrated. What are the actions that people take when harsh, bitter, difficult, and unwilling to negotiate? When they get to counseling place, they say, no, I won't agree. Okay, they say, okay, go home. They say, I'm not going home. I'm going to my grandfather's house. Go, I'm not going anywhere. With this idiot, I'm not going home. No, I'm not going. They start begging you. Unwilling to negotiate. Cold have made that person stiff. Winter have made that fellow stiff.
Are you still here? Unwilling to negotiate.
Argumentative. Every discussion gives back to argument. Every discussion. When you are talking, hey, no, it's a lie. I don't like that. No wonder you said that in 1932. In 1980, you looked attacking, and then
you make sure the guy is snoring before you sleep. Before he gets up, you're already out. Withdraw, you're on your own. You withdraw from everything. Things you do together, you deliberately avoid it. You won't go to church when he knows he's in church. You will come the day he didn't come. And you won't go in the service he goes to. If he goes to first service, you go to second. Change everything. That's winter. Divided voice, divided force, silence and separation. You start keeping quiet. You talk to each other by WhatsApp once in a while. Say hi, informant demon. Reply back, it's your grandfather that is a demon. So you have started again. I was on my own before you started texting me. May God punish you. Like text message. At this, there is selfishness and also self-centeredness. Everybody, I did this, I did that, I am this and that, I am this. Selfishness, because it's winter. At this season, couples are quarrelsome. There's always quarrel in the house, shouting on each other. Always reading negative meaning to
loser. He said, loser. You don't lose, oh loser. Even your family has lost forever. Everything means something negative. Everything. Demons tremble at your presence. It says your father that trembles, not me. What a mighty God. He says, he's calling me a demon. Fine. Everything has a negative meaning. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Everything about you is great. He's calling me a demon. All right. Finding fault, defending self, lonely and reclusive. Even when the house is full, they are always very lonely.
And manage this season well. The marriage and relationship can end there. Hit the rock and the chapter closes. But if it's well managed, it can lead to the next season. If you guys handle each other well.
Now listen, every relationship passes through these seasons I'm showing you. Every
relationship passes through these seasons.
Were there no times you wondered, this person that I married, am I sure I did the right thing?
Were there no times you thought, I think we should break up and close this chapter once and for all so that we can pick up our lives? That is winter setting in.
Some people are at the beginning of winter, while some are inside winter seriously, and they are very cold and they are looking for a way out of that relationship permanently. While some are at the tail end of winter, they are already planning the divorce and the separation. And in fact, they are physically separated.
That one is the tail end of winter. All right, let's go. The fourth season of marriage.
Somebody stole the work lock in this church. Am I correct?
It is the best.
It is time to reap
the good seed you planted at springtime. or the good seeds you planted,
even when you are passing through fall or winter.
Sometimes at fall,
there is problem in the marriage, you are still trying your best to sow good,
to reap it. Even sometimes at winter, you are still sowing good seed, despite the fact that everything is good seed. If you continue, you will reap it, because summer will still come. No season is permanent, except at this time the sun shines longer than night comes. I went to UK during this summer season last year. I discovered that by 10 o'clock, the sun was still out. 10 in the night, the sun was still out. By 4 a.m., the sun came out again. 4 a.m., it was bright like noonday. I said, wonderful. I was coming from, I think it was Albert Odulele's church. By 10 in the night, and the sun was still shining. So I got home, quickly tried to sleep, closed my eyes. By 4:30, a pastor came to take me, because in the morning I was going to come back to Nairobi. So he came to take me to a shopping mall. By 4 a.m., it was bright. How many hours was night? I say it is shorter night and longer day. When you are in summer, it is longer day and shorter night. You have only little disconnection from each other. Over love, over appreciation of each other, over understanding of each other. This is the best season of every relationship. Shorter nights. Little time to disconnect from each other. The rest, you're always around each other. You are connected on phone, on WhatsApp, on Facebook Messenger, on Yahoo, and everything. Hallelujah. Are you still here?
It's time for more. This time, you are more mature
than springtime.
At this time, love is now deliberate. Not that something is pushing you. Your love for that fellow is deliberate. Romance and your time together is calculated into your daily busy schedules. It is, you are satisfied meeting her. You are satisfied meeting him. You are satisfied that the two of you are together. The two of you are connected even when you are far away. Even the little hours that is the night season, you are still connected. You are very happy, you know that fellow. What is the attitude at this season? Trust. Even if he travels to Kutuwenji, you know he's fine. He's not going to commit adultery before he returns home. Commitment to growth and rest
or relaxed mind.
The two of you are committed to making sure your family grows at all costs. Things must work well. You have a relaxed mind. Not when you are traveling, say, hey, I hope there's no girl looking at him. Hey, I know there's no boy. Because there's one boy I saw the other day. At that time, your mind is relaxed because you know that this one, his or her mind is made up to stick in this marriage, and this marriage is working.
Are you hearing me?
The actions at this time is not destructive. It's very constructive actions. The communication flows. That this guy is different from this lady, but
I'm fine with this. We will do this together, and he will do this, I will do this, then we'll come back together again. Are you following somebody?
Yes. Hunger for more growth. You want your marriage to be better. You read more books. You attend seminars. You ask questions. You look at people whose marriages are flourishing. You ask them questions so they can impact you. You read books. You go to seminars. You get your relationship better. You discuss it. This and that that went wrong, let's do it this way.
It's okay, fine.
You don't do this again. I won't do this again. And so on and so forth. The atmosphere around this period is the atmosphere of understanding. Not just love. Understanding.
You now understand each other very well.
Comfortable. You're okay. Attached. Even when you are far away, you are connected to each other. Supportive. You support the person to make. Conflicts are resolved in a matured manner. Not in an amplified way. Hey, I will slap you if I try it. In fact, if you slap me, I will slap you too. In fact, you must be an idiot if you don't slap me. There's no need for all those ones.
You maximize each other's differences positively when you are in summer of your relationship.
Where your wife fits in, she flows there. Where you fit in, you flow there.
Maximizing each other's differences. There are areas where each other is good. You maximize it.
The close
to winter or fall. Same summer. If you do not handle it well, it can fall immediately. That fall may lead to winter. Are you hearing me? Because summer is sweet. Sometimes we get careless until we enter into fall. Are you hearing me, somebody? Now,
you come home by 9:30.
The guy doesn't talk. He believes nothing is wrong. He believes you are fine. You went to your office.
You come back by 2:10. He's okay. He
didn't talk.
You come back by 10:30. He didn't say anything. He trusts you. Everything is fantastic. One day you come back by 2:12. And it's a man that dropped you. And the guy back, the guy dropped you and even came out to hug you. And the guy and your husband were looking at you from the window. If I even took photograph, bam.
That day you enter fall immediately. Am I right? It's because you took it for granted. When you came out by 8, he was fine. 8:30, 9, he increased to 10. When it was now to 12, he was wondering, where's my wife?
You're not dating the guy, but the guy just likes you.
He greets you once in a while. So he only even gave you a hug. Just a hug. Oh. A hug. That hug can destroy your marriage.
Immediately, you enter fall.
And that fall can lead to winter because you are careless.
During summer
and spring, you need to be careful. Spring is sweet. You need to be careful. Summer is very good. You need to be careful. During fall and winter,
you need to walk back your way to either spring or summer. The best is walk your way to summer.
Have you understood now?
Every marriage passes through the four seasons I just showed you now. Every marriage.
Every marriage.
There must be deliberate attempt to fill each other's
love tank. I will talk about that tomorrow. Our time is already done. This is 8:18 or thereabouts. Except the fact that the multimedia people took away the wall clock. But I believe they will restore it tomorrow. Anyway, I think this is 8:18 thereabouts. So let me wind up today's teaching. What are the four seasons of marriage? Tomorrow I'll download some dangerous 7 strategies of season.
Can somebody briefly describe this season? Describe each season. Somebody, anybody here describe the
four seasons?
Sima. I thought that camera was working.
Focus on her and let us see it on the screen. I am not the only one in this church. There are many people in this church. I'm hearing you, ma'am. Yes. It's still not at the extreme, yes.
All right. Somebody describe the winter season here.
Yes, ma'am.
All the problem will show up.
And everybody is cold, shaking. It can carry everybody and scatter the marriage. All right. Somebody describe the summer season here. Somebody describe the summer season here. Oga Dennis, you are here now. Yes, ma. Growth.
The strongest
there is spiritual growth and understanding. You understand each other.
When you've not seen her, you just understand.
When you've not seen him, you just understand. You don't need to start arguing. Say, where are you? Where are you? You started again. There's no need for all that. You just understand that it's at the place of work. Are you understanding? That's summer season. But remember, I told you to be careful during summer so you don't overshoot it. And suddenly you enter fall because of the sweetness of summer that you refuse to sleep when it is night. Are you hearing me? There are many times you get carried away because the marriage is so sweet until trouble starts. When you tell him, when he tells you, let us manifest sexually, say, no, I don't have time for that. He agrees the first time. So after a while, he gets used to you not manifesting and he leaves you alone. Then he starts manifesting with the house help. He starts helping himself because the house help is there to help. So he's helping. Then the day you know, you enter winter immediately. You are the one who caused it. Are you hearing me? You do things, he tries to understand. Say, I understand, my back is bending me now. He says, okay, I understand. He understands. After a while, he will over-understand. It brings problem. Because many times you say, but you understood before. How come you're never understanding now? Ah! The understanding is overstretched. Have you understood now? So summer season is sweet, but don't be carried away. You know, during summer, people travel. They spend all their money in America, in Japan, in UK. Then they return back to Africa to start their life from the scratch because they are mumush. Have you understood now? So please, during summer, be very careful. All right. Now let us check. In your own estimation, where is your marriage? In your own calculation, with what I've taught you now, where is your marriage? Is anybody want to tell me? With what I've just shown you now, with this exposure to this uncommon teaching that I just taught you today, where is your marriage? Or where is your relationship? How many of you are in a relationship? Raise your hand. You are in a relationship. Raise your hand now. You are afraid now. Why are you now shaking? You are in a relationship. Very good. Where is your relationship? Is it in summer or spring or fall or winter? Eh? Oga Moses, you have not seen vision yet. You need to sleep. Eh? Am I right? You need to sleep. After sleeping like Adam, he will see clearly. He has not slept. Madam, close your eyes. Oh, Jerry, you don't learn. Do you know anything? Pretend you didn't know anything.
She's even writing notes. She knows many things. Yes, ma'am. Spring. Anybody else? Yes, ma'am. Is this springing? Well. Eh? This one that you're looking at me and doing your face one close this board for you and you think we don't know.
Their life. Few times they enter into fall, they move out again and enter into summer.
Few times they enter into winter, maybe for like 1 week, 2 weeks, they quarrel, then they return back
to summer again. Have you understood?
They have small winter, small fall, more summer.
But good spring, have you understood?
This spring, you overlook a lot of things. During spring, the guy is in the midst of eminent personalities, and the guy download guys.
And you?
You cover him up. But when spring is getting to an end, every season can end. Every season can also be elongated. When it gets to an end, when it tries that, you can say in public, why did you do that? You would have forgotten you did it.
That day you can start your fall. Have you understood?
If you do not know how to handle
spring well,
if you get carried away and you get very careless, or you are too rigid, you want it this way. If it doesn't move this way,
you will enter into winter immediately. Have you understood? So that's what happened to them.
But every marriage
passes through these forces.
Give me mic. People are hearing us.
People are texting me that they are watching.
Is there an estimated time span that each season can take.
It's only spring we can estimate. Do that camera well. It's only spring we can estimate. Spring is from the beginning of the relationship into honeymoon. Some few weeks or months after honeymoon, spring ends.
That's the truth.
But fall, you can fall for life. You can also fall for a few days
or a few hours.
Winter, you can have winter for a few hours. You can have winter for the rest of your life. Summer, you can have summer for a few days or have summer for the rest of your life, depending on your maturity. Tomorrow, I'll teach you how to navigate from one season to the other. There are 7 steps to navigate. If you know, it will be easy for you. So, it's only spring that we know that people can enjoy that spring and be liking him and be liking him and be like. That is why some people, they permanently get engaged. They don't want to marry. Because the day you get married, the season must start changing. Are you understanding me? Some people don't want to get into marriage. They pretend. Deliberate love. That one. You have to deliberately love. So, it's only spring we can estimate the time. The others can be for 1 hour or for a lifetime or for a few days,
depending on how matured you are and how you know how to navigate.
Marriage and honeymoon. One can still go through the 4 seasons. So I don't think spring is constantly in courtship relationship, because I ever read about a marriage counselor that said that when people intending to get
above your head in your life, I know, Sister Alice, you've not now. Nah, don't let your daddy hear.
Spring is always a bit longer. But sometimes if you are matured, summer will be long. In relationship, you can experience the 4 seasons. When you are still courting each other, you can even quarrel. Enter winter, you don't want to talk to each other for like 3 months. Then later you say hello again and you start. You can see the seasons keep rotating, but there are 4 seasons you experience in relationship
or marriage or both. Those 4 seasons keep rotating.
So what she said is also correct. You can experience the 4 seasons when you are still courting, when you are even still dating. In fact, many times you can experience the first season of spring and the next day you enter winter instantly. Why? Because the person did something that pissed you off and you fell and you entered winter immediately and you don't want to see the guy anymore. Yes. In fact, that is what saves you from adultery or extramarital affair. There are times you see somebody, you just like the person, you just like the person. Then the person just does one thing. Then you remember you're a Christian. Who is this fellow?
You quickly cut off. Am I right? Start texting him. Say, wow, you bought me long shoe. May you live long. The little wires, you say, you gave me 3 meat. May the Trinity support you. You start
wearing jeans. Wearing jeans. I'm playing by the palm tree. Spring has started again. If you know how to navigate, you can move out of winter
back into spring or summer.
Summer is when you navigate out of spring and the two of you now
gather again to yourself with understanding.
Spring is when you come out of winter and you start running after each other again, start brewing the love again.
Have you understood? You understand? So if it's still long in winter, the relationship will close. Both relationship and marriage will die. Because cold kills. I heard the story of some certain people that were arrested in the days of Hitler. It was because he was giving that man warmth. They were exchanging that warmth. That was how they were alive. Everybody were all alone. They froze to death in the train. When it is winter and the two of you are apart, you can freeze to death. You will. That's why you see some people, they don't know that their wife have died in the other room. 3 days, everywhere is smelling. Now enter, she's already getting rot. Why? She died of heartache. The relationship was in winter. So they never cared whether she's there or not. They greet each other once in 2 weeks or when they meet in church. to pretend so that the pastor will not know that they are quarreling. All right, two men are close. Is anybody else? Ask yours. Anybody else? So I know. Two more and I close. Yes. All right.
You have taught us that in marriage, also in relationships, it's good when you accept.
But the person that is still sober among them should go for counseling and learn keys by which you can convert the proud one. The person that doesn't want to accept fault is proud. That other person needs counseling and peace. You need the right person to tell you what to do so that you can use of influence to influence this other stubborn person to change. Some husbands have been able to change their wives, and some wives have been able to change their husbands that are very, very stubborn. That refuse to accept anything. They will keep loving him, love him until he breaks.
Except the more tough they get.
So that's where you now need the God dimension. Thursday, I'll talk about the God dimension. All right, talk to me now.
Okay, question number two.
Yes.
I've heard in many cases people saying that they fear maybe ladies from church or men from church because they say whenever you...
Slowly together, same step. Have you... Relationships change. As soon as there is marriage, the same man that used to get water for you to take your bath or for you to brush your teeth will change. He will assume his manly role while you assume your wifely role. Are you understand? Things will change instantly. If not for that, maybe after 1, 2, 3, 4 weeks or 1 month, things table will turn a bit. Gradually, you see the guy now telling you, can you give me that thing? Can you do that thing? Before, he would do it for you and together. But now he will tell you to do it because he believes he's your husband. He will tell you what to do. So if you do not have that understanding that there is a shift, no matter his age,
Rain will beat the guy. He's okay. He will just do his high and say, I'm fine.
But after marriage, Rain will not beat him. As soon as marriage happens, the roles.
Man sees you kneel down for a pastor, he believes you kneel down for him. And he gets married to of hypocrisy. But there are ladies that are genuine. When you see counterfeit, it means there's original. There are ladies that are genuine. The word of God have entered them. They are very humble. They are just very humble. And many times, many people come to church to pick up such ladies because they are very humble and they useless them and they deal with them brutally. May God deliver such ladies. I always see sometimes many good ladies marrying wicked men. Fall in love. You need to be careful to note whether this person is genuinely saved. Prayer, fasting, and commitment. You will check the commitment level. One thing to know before you say, I do.
You will get those ones. Have you understood now? So there are no wicked people generally in church. There are only few hypocrites in church. And even in the days of Jesus, there were some. That's why Jesus called them hypocrites. Have you understood? Did I answer you? I think we should close here. Finally. Is the communion already? Good.
So my question is,
yes, sir.
What stage of relationship, or can you be able to experience two seasons at a go? Or really, what happens when you fight? People have what they call love-hate relationship. You love the person, but you hate the person.
You love the person, but you hate the person.
You want to go away, but you still want to come back.
You want to go away, and you want to come back.
You actually telling the person, I'm leaving you, but the next day you are saying sorry. So what usually happens? What season of relationship is
okay,
that?
I have the answer. The answer to that one is,
one season is finishing,
and a new one wants to begin. It's either fall or winter wants to finish and spring or summer wants to start. That is
happens within a time frame. Do you know that you can enter summer as you are saying, sweetheart, we've been quarreling for a while,
but you know, I want to surprise you to make you understand that I don't mean all these things that I'm doing.
Everything was fantastic. And then suddenly, you meet the guy in front of the house. Somebody just giving him a kiss.